In this video, I'm going to go deep into keyword targeting for YouTube ads, how it works, and what are some best practices for how to use it. My name is Kyle Sulerud. I'm the creator of a YouTube targeting software called VidHoarder. And if you want more videos like this about YouTube ads and how to make them work, be sure to hit the subscribe button right now. Now, when it comes to keyword targeting for YouTube ads, do you consider yourself a beginner or an expert or somewhere in between? Comment below, let me know where you're at right now with your knowledge of YouTube ads keyword targeting. Let's talk about how keyword targeting works on YouTube, because this is something that trips a lot of people up. Once you tell Google which keywords to target with your YouTube ads, there are actually two main things that the system is going to look at. It's going to look at the videos, the relevant videos that your ad is going to play on. So if you're adding a keyword like business, then theoretically, your ad is going to play on videos that are about business. And I'm sure that's your intent when you're adding keywords. Most people adding a keyword think that their ad is going to show on videos related to that keyword. And that's what trips people up, because that's not the only thing that's going to happen when you are adding keywords to a YouTube ad campaign. The other thing that's going to happen is Google is going to show your ad to audiences who may be interested in those keywords. And you don't have to take my word for that. You can go directly to Google's documentation and they'll tell you the same thing. So keywords are going to target related videos, related content, and also audiences who are interested in those keywords. So that's where things can get out of hand, because even then, it's not just someone who was searching for a certain keyword or browsing websites related to a certain keyword. Google reaches much, much farther than that. Let me explain with an oversimplified example. So let's say that I, as a Google user, I like rock climbing and camping and jazz music and babies. And Paul, my video producer, also likes rock climbing and camping and jazz music and babies. But Paul also really likes cupcakes. Now, because Paul and I share so many of the same interests, Google concludes that I must also like cupcakes. So I start to see ads that are being shown to people who definitely like cupcakes. Now, this is despite me personally never having shown an interest in cupcakes, but I share so many of the same characteristics as people who do like cupcakes that I get lumped into that same group. Now, again, this is a very oversimplified explanation. Google takes a lot of factors into account. It looks for a lot of connections among a lot of different people. But hopefully it gives you some idea of how imperfect keyword targeting can be. Now, does that mean you shouldn't use keyword targeting? No, that's not what I'm saying at all. In fact, let's talk about some best practices you can utilize when you are targeting with keywords in your YouTube ad campaigns. First, I better mention match types. If you're used to using Google search ads, then you know there are different keyword match types: exact match, phrase match, broad match. With YouTube ads, those aren't a thing. So don't worry about match types at all. You're just going to be adding these keywords to the campaign. No brackets, no quotation marks, nothing like that. The first thing I recommend you do with your keywords is mix things up with a variety of shorter keywords and longer keywords. For example, if I'm trying to reach people interested in YouTube ads, I might have a keyword like YouTube ads. I can also have keywords like how to run YouTube ads, how to set up a YouTube ads campaign. So I'm not only using shorter keywords, I'm not only using longer keywords, I'm mixing it up as much as I can and basically adding as many keywords as I can. The second thing I'll mention though is not to use keywords that are too short or too basic. So again, if I'm trying to reach people interested in YouTube ads, I would not include the keyword YouTube, and I wouldn't include the keyword ads. Those keywords by themselves are just too broad and it's going to bring me too much irrelevant traffic. The third thing I'll recommend is to get some help from Google's system. You can use the keyword planner to help you research keywords, but you can also do this right within the ad account as you're setting up the campaign. Once you've added a few keywords, Google is going to start recommending some similar keywords to you. Now, you don't want to add all of these. You want to make sure they're good and relevant to what you're offering, but this will help you add keywords that are already in the system. They're already recognized by Google's system. So there's a good chance you'll be able to get some decent traffic if you're adding the keywords that Google is recommending. The fourth thing that I recommend is to add a lot of keywords. Now, I kind of already said that, but you really need to take this to the extreme. You need to add a lot of keywords and a lot of variations. So, for example, I might add a keyword like build YouTube ads campaigns. I'd also add the variation build YouTube ad campaigns. Notice the word ad was plural the first time and singular the second time. A small difference, but those two keywords could be very different in terms of the traffic Google is going to send me. I would also add things like how to build YouTube ads campaigns and how to build YouTube ad campaigns. So you really just want to go in depth here and come up with as many relevant keywords and variations on those keywords as you can. And you should end up with hundreds of keywords that you're targeting within your YouTube ad campaigns. The fifth thing to consider is to add brand names as keywords. You can add competitors' brand names, whether that's the name of a company or the name of a person. You can also add your own name or the name of your company. These keywords can sometimes work phenomenally well as YouTube ads keywords. And then lastly, once you have all these keywords added, it's time to run the campaign. So that's not where it stops. Once you're running the campaign, that's where a lot of the work comes in, because now you're going to be looking at each of these keywords. Remember, we've added hundreds of them, and you're going to see how they're performing. If they are not performing well, you need to start getting rid of them. If you find keywords that are performing really well, try to figure out more variations related to those keywords. At this stage, you're trying to get rid of what is not working, and you're trying to capitalize on what is working. So to summarize, keyword targeting for YouTube ads is very imprecise, but it can work really well, and it can really help you scale a campaign if you have an offer that's working. Because of how broad the targeting can be sometimes, that opens up a lot of opportunities for traffic and can help you grow a campaign quickly. For keyword targeting to have the best chance of working for you, you want to add a lot of keywords. And then run the campaign, eliminate what is not working, and build on what is working. I hope this video was helpful. If it was, make sure you hit the like button. It really helps out my channel. And check out my Vid Hoarder software. Vid Hoarder was built to help you better reach your target customer with YouTube ads. There's a link in the description so you can go check out Vid Hoarder right now, and I'll see you in the next video.